Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn the experience together. Today we are going to have Biology Form 3, Lesson 7, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on Classification 2 under the subtopic Phylum Chordata, that is the chordates. But before that, we can have the following lesson goals, whereby you are required by the end of the lesson, you should be able to give the general characteristics of both the phylum Chordata and the class Pisces. Welcome. These include, actually, the phylum Chordata. The members include the fishes, the amphibians, the reptiles, birds, and mammals. The term Chordata was derived from the term notochord, whereby the notochord is a long, flexible rod-like structure found in chordates. In some members, this structure persists even in adulthood. In the vertebrates, this exists only in the embryonic stages of development. It is replaced by a vertebral column in later stages of embryology. The phylum Chordata includes both types of animals, that is, those which the notochord persists and also those which the notochord does not persist. We have got now general characteristics of members of this class, whereby as I am going now to highlight the general characteristics, you will be required to see whether you will able to identify these characteristics from our examples. Some of the examples, we have got human beings, we also have got the fish, we also have hyena, we also have tortoise, we have lizard, and also we have got the bats. So I'm going to give the general characteristics of these chordates, and you'll be able to observe them in these diagrams which are on our screen. So the first general characteristics is that members of this phylum have a notochord, at least at some stages of their development. This is found on the dorsal side of the body. Two, chordata are bilaterally symmetrical, whereby we mean that if you cut them, you'll be able to get two identical parts. Three, they have a single dorsal tubular nerve cord. In higher chordates, it develops into brain anteriorly and the spinal cord posteriorly. The spinal cord is enclosed in the vertebral column. Another characteristics of that is phylum Chordata, they have physeral clefts. What I mean by the physeral clefts is that these are the slits perforating the body walls at the pharynx. In fish, these slits become the gills. In higher chordates, slits are only present in the embryo. So you might not be able to see the slits on our diagrams here because these are fully grown organisms. But the only slits that we are able to observe from our diagram are only represented by the fish, which here represented by the gills, but for the organisms, actually the slits are found in their embryos. We have another characteristic that the heart is ventrally located. The blood flows to the heart through veins that are ventrally placed. It flows from the heart through dorsally placed arteries. Another characteristic is that they have a closed circulatory system. Another one is that they have segmented muscle blocks known as myotubes on either side of their body. They possess a another characteristic is that they possess an internal skeleton. They possess an internal skeleton, that is about the phylum Chordata. We are going now to get in class Pisces, whereby they fall under the phylum Chordata. So class Pisces, these are the fishes. Actually, members of these are the fishes. We can have a diagrammatic representation of different fishes. A number of fishes have a skeleton made up of cartilage, e.g. you can have the shark. Others, such as tilapia, have a skeleton made up of bone. Other examples of fish include, you can have the Nile perch, we have lungfish, rayfish. There are so many. We have got, so this is just a diagrammatic presentation of some of the fish. We are going to look at the general characteristics of the this class, whereby one, we can say they have gills for gaseous exchange in water. Two, movement is by means of fins. You can see the fins from our diagram. Three, their bodies are covered by scales. Four, they have a streamlined body, as you can see. They do not possess the middle or the external ear. Six, they possess a lateral line system for sensitivity. Seven, their heart consists of two main chambers, that is the auricle and the ventricle, with single circulatory system. Another characteristic is that body temperature changes to the environment that which they belong. In other words, we say that they are ectothermic, and their eyes are covered by a nictitating membrane for sensitivity. Having done and said that, can have the following activity whereby you are required to identify six characteristics of the chordates. For more information in this lesson, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Student Book 3, Nairobi, that is the Kenya Literature Bureau. And also to get this and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an